Two front strikers, Graeme and Dalglish. So Strachan trying to make space. Good running by Gemmill. Gemmill thinking for a left foot shot. Strachan okay for the return pass. Strachan in with a great chance. And for the goal! Strachan scores a superb 1-2.
שחקנים מולו עובר את השלושה אפילו מקשית למרכז וחיים בר לקרן חיים בר נגיחה נועזת בהשתתחות נגיחה כמעט נועשת מן ההקשתה פנימה של רוברטסון ועכשיו ברן שם אחד הגבוהים של הסקוטי מחכה לכדור מקליש בהזדמנות והכדור בפנים דלגליש 1-0 לסקוטלנד
contingent merging with the Scottish at that corner flag as the second half gets underway and Northern Ireland come forward immediately. That's a long try from Jerry Armstrong.
Very well beaten by O'Neill, but O'Neill leaning on the shoulders of Gray according to the East German referee. Free kick already taken. This is McGrain to Archibald. And that's why Steve Archibald has notched up 24 goals in England this season. Taking the ball inside from McGrain. Magnificent turn onto his left foot. And the shot appeared to be being Pat Jennings and blocked by the post. Once again providing the linchpin in midfield. Now McLeish. Patient build-up from Scotland. Gemmill to Archibald. Andy Gray. It was only a snap chance, but the Scottish striker was already showing that they're prepared to have a dig from the edge of the box at any opportunity. Long ball aim for Wark. That's a great ball to Andy Gray. Now Steve Archibald. And headed off the line. Well, that should have been the first goal to Scotland. A great save on the line by Chris Nicol. The build-up. Quite superb. John Wark hitting that long ball from Kenny Burns into the path of Andy Gray. He looked as though he'd have a shot on his own, but squared it to Steve Archibald. He really should have taken it first time. Stumbled, turned on it, and that delay giving Nicol the chance to get back to hit it off the line. Good run, angle run from Gray. Wark in support. So is Burns. Gray's wide on the left, but here's John Wark for Scotland. Well, a deadly finishing. He's got him 32 goals this season, lets him down. But a much better build-up from Scotland. The through ball opening up that Northern Ireland defence, giving Wark the shooting chance he normally relishes. Neilson with that long throw. Back it comes to McCreary. And Michael Roy. Neilson playing it in, Hamilton in the box. And that's a great save by Alan Ruff, touching the ball onto the post. Well, that would certainly have been a killer blow for Northern Ireland. A deflated ball from Sammy Neilson. Hamilton under pressure, got his head to it, going in at the top corner, and there's Ruff just touching it onto that post. Gray with a kick for Scotland. Kenny Burns in the box. McLeish at the far post. Well, a shooting chance for John Wark, but that's what makes Pat Jennings such a great goalkeeper. A great shooting opportunity for John Wark. He hit it very firmly indeed, but Jennings made that look easy. Hamilton, the far side of the box with Jerry Armstrong. Michael Roy. Billy Hamilton makes it 1-0 to Northern Ireland. Well, that's the bonus Northern Ireland were looking for on the blow that Scotland were dreading. A perfectly orthodox driven free kick by Sammy Michael Roy. The Scottish marking thoroughly unsatisfactory. Hamilton's glancing header. And Northern Ireland go in front. Team scored more than one goal. Portugal scored three. Ireland scored three against Sweden. In every other match, no side has scored more than once. And that's how tough it is. That's towards Wark. John Wark equalises for Scotland. The goal he's always been wanting. A crucial goal for Scotland. 13 minutes left. Scotland go level. It split the Irish defence. Wark coming in at pace. And the driven ball leaving Pat Jennings with no chance at all. McGray walks in the box. Well, John Wark certainly making his presence felt in the Irish box. But Sammy Neilson did very well, marking his run, jumping with him, and giving him no clear header at Pat Jennings' goal. Scottish team now full of urgency. Robertson's corner kick, there's Andy Gray. Now Steve Archibald. Well, I think Archibald thought the whistle had gone. Well, we'll watch, the 90 minutes have now come and gone. Throw to Scotland. So as we go into injury time, the long ball forward looking for Archibald. This is Wark leaving it to Gemmill. Hartford to Archibald, and the referee allowing very little additional time. The final whistle goes, Scotland 1, Northern Ireland 1. The Irish players very happy, and so will that man, John Wark, be happy, because his goal, near the end, equalising the earlier goal of Billy Hamilton for Northern Ireland, tying it up a point apiece in Group 6.
Un penalty sur Robertson. Vous l'avez deviné, les Écossais jouent ensemble. C'est ce même Robertson qui se fait justice au ras du poteau. 1-0. C'était la 21e minute de jeu. Alors à la 30e, un deuxième penalty, toujours tiré par Robertson. Du même côté, le gardien n'y a pas cru. 2-0. 54e minute de jeu. Un but qui va être réussi pour les Écossais par Provan. 3-0, la cause est entendue, même si pour l'honneur, à la 57e minute de jeu, les Israéliens vont réduire la marque par l'intermédiaire de Sinaï. Score final, 3-1.
Sinaï, 3-1. 6, Écosse-Suède, Glasgow, 20e minute de jeu, un coup franc de Robertson et une tête de Jordan. Le cliché est habituel, cela rapporte un but. 80e minute de jeu, une faute sur Andy Gray dans la surface. L'arbitre est navré, mais respecte le règlement. Et c'est Robertson, l'homme des coups de pied arrêtés, qui transforme ce pénalty en but 2 à 0. L'Écosse, avec 10 points, est pratiquement qualifiée.
Archibald, and it was curling just too high. Scott's there, look at they left a little bit of space there, and Armstrong, if it had fallen for him, he'd have been happier. But there's no way yet, and a touch there, and a shot by McElroy in the end that was just wide. And suddenly Scotland were... Robertson coming to this side of the field to tackle and try and get it out. Little Gordon Scotland. Oh, he's brought down by McCreary, and again, he's a very lenient referee. I thought there was a foul there, but the referee allowed it to go, and here's Archibald. Snuff out that Scottish away. Stewart, Miller playing a good, sensible, simple ball there to Stratton. Now Souness playing it forward. Donaghy losing out to Stratton. Is this a chance for Archibald? A flick! Over the top! Ireland very nearly presented Donaghy a goal there. Now Donaghy losing out, and some quick thinking here by Steve Archibald, lifting it at the outside of his boot over Pat Jennings, but just over the bar.
Gary Armstrong just keeping it in play. The big man from the back was almost in there on something at the far post. And suddenly Stockton looked very vulnerable indeed. There he is, but he didn't quite get the connection he wanted.
We'll be right back.